have not heard is the fact that when you divide the hallway in half, one school gets the student bathrooms, one school doesn't. And if you think that the principal who's in here somewhere, I believe he's back there, of the Future Roads program is gonna get up here and tell you that this space is not good for his school, he won't have a school. So he's not gonna necessarily do right by our children. Educators didn't necessarily make the decision about the space here. Because when educators get together, they make sound decisions for our kids.
And the first thing we always do is make sure the school works for kids.
School is not a community, this is a family. A family consisting of Bronx Regional Satellite and the GED and Life program. Well, I'm a part of this community, this family, and I felt very disrespected when my child came back from her regional break and found out that this school would be a part of a co-located program. I'm a partaker and a shareholder of this family. I don't expect nothing less from the DOE and the other shareholders. No disrespect to anyone, but because you decided to come up with this idea, never thought of how it would impact the rest of us. What a brilliant idea. You, this is what you did. You made a bad cocktail mix.
Because of schools like this, I have an education and I'm able to present myself. You know, Satellite is like the stage over here, which I was able to stand on and present myself in a way to people that's going to be like, hey, he's amazing.
Our schedule is unique and it works. Among our CBOs, our students work with Mothers on the Move, Rocking the Boat, and Grow NYC. Each requires that we have a block schedule that allows time for experiential learning. Placing another school on our floor would mean that our schedule would change, and so could our relationships with our CBOs.
To us, students past and present, it is a whole new world that only a few of us have had the pleasure of knowing. For most of us, Satellite gave us a second chance to obtain our diplomas, as well as teaching us about our communities and how we can be a part of making the world around us a positive one. At Satellite, we are taught that our worlds expand further than our neighborhoods. Had it not been for Satellite, I wouldn't know that my voice can make a difference. Had it not been for the amazing, dedicated teachers at this school, I probably wouldn't be here speaking on behalf of a school that not only changed my life, but the lives of all those that came here.
Currently, I share a classroom because there isn't enough space. But we are being told by people who have not been to the school and perused the school that you have too much space. Something is wrong with that logic. I want to know, why is it that we in this community here have to confront this kind of problem that Bronx Science would not have to confront, that Stuyvesant wouldn't have to confront, but we have to confront? Is this, as some people are talking about, is this class warfare?
Yeah.
Why are we being dumped off? Because here we are expressing ourselves and the decisions are supposed to be democratic decision making. Let's see if that were to be obtained here after this meeting this afternoon, or if it is a cynical process and this proposal has already been confirmed.
And you know
a plan is being concocted to irreparable damage to these two programs. Why is that? But I am pretty confident that the education that the well-heeled get, the education that students get in some parts of Westchester and other places is different. The spatial arrangement is different. Students have a different experience. But here, we are supposed to be crowded in like cockroaches, and we are supposed to get a quality education to compete with those same students who come out from the schools on the Upper West Side, who come out of the schools from Westchester. We, our students, are supposed to compete with them when they have superior facilities and superior resources. Something has to be done. The nonsense has has to stop. You must give our children a chance to be successful.
Satellite gave my son a second chance. He wasn't doing that before.
Why not use the resources that you have at your disposal to actually do outreach in the community and find out what the community needs beforehand, talking to them? Like, wouldn't that be a much better choice in order to actually serve those kids? And also use those resources to create more actual housing options for the schools?
Schools need to be invested in to succeed. Schomburg Satellite Academy has existed for decades and has worked near miracles on a shoestring budget well before the latest austerity measures. Schomburg Satellite Academy has changed young people's lives. These are people, not data points. This is a school community that is for the community. Decisions that are made at desks and administrative offices far from here with predetermined outcomes do not speak for the community. Sham hearings do not speak for the community. I truly believe that for a school community to succeed, it needs investment. It needs the resources. It needs community connections. Look at what Schomburg Satellite has accomplished without the investment from the Department of Education.
I'm doing this so that we can create options for all of our kids in our communities, and that I will be here to work with everyone.
Power is in the student body here. They have to organize, and they're organizing. How much is the head of ROADS making? Or the principal, the guy who came here is making? I mean, this is an issue of profit, basically. And the issue of accountability is very important. We need to connect, basically. We need to connect with other schools that are going through the same problem.
Yes.
The issue is not collocation. The issue is, at this moment, they're supporting us because, I mean, it's so outrageous that they want to destroy us directly, but the issue is basically the profit model. And secondly, that the working people don't have any say in the United States. It's the banks and the state that they have. We have to change through the working people to lead the country. And
I urge you to engage with these people, with this community, with these educators, with these students. Engage, actively listen to what they are saying to you. I understand that you've made your decision. I have no problem with charter schools. I believe that co-location is not the answer for this building.
And we asked the DOE point blank, can we grow? Can Bronx Regional grow? Can Satellite grow? And this is the question that I posed to you tonight. The DOE's Office of Portfolio and Planning said, no, we believe in small schools. Well, I went home and I did some research and I found out that the DOE is opening 8 new schools in New York City next year with an average size of 453 students. Now, to grow to fill the space, Satellite would need to have 300, 320 students. Bronx Regional would need to have 400, 420 at the most. Our students are amazing. And our visitors tonight, if you only knew, the students of ROADS will be amazing as well. And they have great futures ahead of them, but they deserve better than being smashed into a room where they share bathrooms, where they share science labs and computer rooms, where they share, we're supposed to have individual attention for every student, and that's not possible under education. Educational equity means that 453 students in other new DOE programs means that 300 students in Satellite is okay. And educational equity means schools that are designed for success. I support ROADS2 and I support them in their own building. Thank you all for staying this long tonight.
And the first thing we always do is make sure the school works for kids.
Stand up, fight back!
Stand up, fight back!